Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a really exciting video because I've been looking forward to testing out Burt's Bees makeup. That's right, this video has been a long time coming because I've been collecting all these products. I have quite a few items that I'm going to be testing out today and also doing a wear test. As far as what we're going to be testing out, first I'm going to talk about the liquid foundation, which is quite a controversial product because it has some not so great reviews and then also some raving reviews. So we'll be talking about that today. Then we're going to be talking about this powder/powder foundation. Then we're going to talk about the blush. Then we're gonna move right along to eyes, and I have an eye pencil and also a brow pencil, and then we're gonna finish off with lip products, which, by the way, these were 2016 Allure Best of Beauty winners, so we have to definitely check these ones out as well. And I guess with that being said, let's jump into the application and the review process, but not before you like this video and subscribe to my channel. And with that being said, let's jump in, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. All right, we're gonna start with the foundation. This is Goodness Glows Liquid Makeup Foundation. This is what it looks like right here. The packaging does have a pump. This is $17, so not very cheap. It does come in 12 shades, and my shade, by the way, is linen beige, and all of the items I'm using today and all the colors will be listed down below in case you're curious. As far as the ingredients, this is 98.9% natural. It does have some oils, quite a few of them when I was looking at the ingredients list, so it's probably best for those of you who have either normal to combinational to dry skin. I do have oily skin, although right now it's being kind of finicky and it's also dry at the same time because it's winter and my skin doesn't know what it is. As far as the claims, I'm gonna read you what I wrote in my notes. It's full coverage mineral makeup that leaves skin smoother and more radiant with a natural finish that's never heavy, cakey, or greasy. All right, with that being said, let's apply this. I am going to apply it with two methods. I'm gonna use a beauty blender first. I remember when I did apply a little while ago that I had some issues with applying it with a beauty blender, but I kind of forgot what those were, so I brought a makeup brush as well. This foundation, I don't know if it's bad, but it has a weird smell. Like, it just smells unpleasant. Not like chemically, but like something went bad. You know when you like apply something on your face and like it has a bad smell, and it's not like that strong, but because it's so close to your nose, you're like, that's what's happening right now to me. This is what I was experiencing earlier when I was applying this a couple of days ago. It kind of sticks to the skin, but then also like it's really easy to take it off. Like, you go like this and some of the foundation just like comes off. But as far as the difference between the two sides, here it is. It is a dewy finish, but it's not overly dewy. So if you have oily skin or you just don't like that heavy greasy feeling, this is not going to give you that, which is surprising because I thought, especially when first trying it out and like having it go on patchy and weird and not stick to my skin, I thought this was going to be a disastrous foundation. It's not. The finish is actually quite nice. It doesn't have a super high coverage. It probably has like a medium coverage, but that's fine. You can see pores, but it does not accentuate them. They are what they are, but it does have a beautiful, healthy, glowy, but not too glowy finish. I love the finish of this foundation. I'm so down for that kind of like a wearable. Anybody can pretty much pull off this kind of a glowy finish. It's so sad because they got it so right with the finish and so wrong with the sticky level. But I did find that applying it with a brush works pretty well. So on the other side, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply it with the brush. All right, you guys, so this is the foundation up close. I think it kind of sits on the skin, not cakey per se, but it definitely, you can see the texture of this foundation. But the worst thing about this foundation by far is the fact that it goes on patchy, and then as soon as you touch your face, even ever so gently, like the foundation just comes off. All right, moving on to the next thing, which is actually one of my favorite products from this line, which is the mattifying powder foundation. This is what it looks like. Let me just open it up for you to show you the packaging. And by the way, I do love this like beehive. What's this shape called? Hexagon? I think it's really cute and fitting for the whole like bee theme. On the other side of this, there is a secret compartment with the same shape sponge, which I'm not gonna use because I don't use these sponges, but if you do, it's here and it's a very cute, unique shape. And oh, by the way, there's a mirror right there as well. This is $17, the same price as the liquid foundation. It comes in 6 shades, so half the shades of the foundation. So you basically get 1 shade of powder for 2 shades of foundations. It is 100% natural, non-comedogenic, shine control formula that lets you build coverage gradually as needed. So this is great for people with oily, acne-prone skin because, again, it gets rid of the shine and it also is non-comedogenic, which means it's unlikely to cause acne. Nothing is for certain, keep that in mind, but it's a good start. And it's made with bamboo to blur imperfections. This mineral makeup blends easily to smooth and even skin while absorbing oil without drying out skin. One thing I do want to talk about is that it does get kind of like crumbly when you use it. It's not like the smoothest product. It does get a little like fluffy. It's not a huge deal. I just want to let you know that in case you're into that kind of a thing. Right, I'm going to set my under eyes with this. Not necessarily the kind of product I would use to set my under eyes. I think I would prefer like a loose powder, but for this video, I will do that. And it's not a bad powder to set under eyes with either. Okay, I'm gonna do half of my face just to show you the difference. This redeems the liquid foundation for sure. I mean, for $17, I think you can get a lot of nice quality powders, but if you're looking for one that is 100% natural, then this one is not a bad one to check out at all. Actually really, really like it. This is the dewy side. This is the mattified side. And I like layering this powder on top of dewy foundations. Even this one right here, even though I don't like the foundation itself, I do like the finish, and it just gives you the most like beautiful glow from within because you have like this glowy finish and then on top you have the mattifying finish, so you have like this blurry but then also like glowy look to your skin, which I'm definitely into. It's kind of like a healthy matte finish. All right, we are up close again, and this is the foundation and the powder foundation, one on top of the other. The powder gives you a nice matte finish. It doesn't really blur things out too much, but it does give you a good amount of coverage for a powder product like this. You can see all my pores still. But again, if you put something different underneath the powder, then obviously you'll get slightly different results. But it does not make things cakey, you know. When you have a cakey foundation like this, it's not exactly cakey, but you know, one that has some texture to it. This powder does not add to it. If anything, it just like takes a little bit off. All right, moving right along to the blush, which has the same packaging as the powder, except it's a little bit smaller and it does not have a mirror. It just has the actual blush on the inside. This is $10, so a lot cheaper than the foundations. Comes in 3 colors, and my color is called Bare Peach. It is 100% natural, lightweight mineral makeup, applies and blends easily and evenly to enhance your cheeks' natural glow. If you look in here though, you're like, what glow? But when you apply this on your cheeks, you'll see. So let me just take my brush and show you what I mean. This is pretty matte looking, right? Well, watch this. I mean, this brings the glow. It's like hidden glow. Look at that. It has a really good color payoff. It does have a little bit of fallout though, so be careful with that. Make sure to tap off the excess because then you're going to have either just like a bunch of stuff on your clothes or your makeup table or a lot of blush on your face. It does go on really beautifully. It blends out pretty easily and it's a beautiful finish, but it does have a lot of glow. Like, look at that. It's almost like a highlighter and blush in one, even though you're looking in the pan and it's like, where's the highlighter? It's definitely there, which I don't love blushes that do have this much shimmer because it accentuates my pores and my acne, and this is where I have the most pores and acne. So I prefer more of like a matte to satin finish blush, but I do like it a lot. I feel like you can get a lot of nice drugstore blushes for even cheaper than this, but if you're looking for something that is 100% natural and has that shimmer built into it, this is a great blush to check out. I do like it a lot. Moving down to the eye area, I do have the Burt's Bees Nourishing Eyeliner, and my color is warm brown. I actually really like this product a lot. This is $10 and it comes in 3 colors, basically black, brown, and gray, although I think the names are probably like fancier than that. And this is what the packaging looks like. It is a wooden pencil, so you have to sharpen it. There's no twisty thing, which is pretty convenient, but it's old school right here. It is 99.9% natural. It's fade and smudge resistant color that beautifully defines and enhances your eyes with long lasting wear. What I like about this pencil though is the color. It's kind of like a warm brown with a little bit of shimmer to it. But the main thing I like about this pencil is how it applies. So let me just show you really quickly. It goes on creamy and pigmented, like so. But then you can take your finger and blend this out, and it almost turns into like a powder-ish kind of a product. Because sometimes creamy liners are really hard to blend out and they drag and they're patchy. This one goes on creamy and beautifully, but then like you blend it out and it's quick and easy and it just works. So if you like to do what I do in the mornings when you just don't feel like going crazy with your eye look and you just like to tick, tick, tick and then blend it out, I mean, it just gives you a little bit of something right away. So I love that a lot about this liner. I also really like the color. If you like a more natural colored eyeliner, browns are really great. There are a lot of good pencils out there, but this is definitely one of them, and I really like it a lot. All right, I'm going to finish the rest of my makeup, but before I do that, I want to show you the brow pencil. It comes in two colors only, and my color is blonde. It has two ends to it. One end is the actual pencil and the other one is the spoolie, kind of standard. I'm not crazy about the spoolie, but it does the job of brushing the brows through. It is 99.9% natural, defines, shapes brows, and the brush easily blends color and grooms brows is what it says online. And it does have a really, really creamy finish to it. You see, it just gives you a lot of color, but you have to also be careful with that because you don't want to overdo it. And I think with this pencil, it's almost like pomade in a pencil form. And I'm not a huge fan of pomades, but if you are, I think you're gonna like this pencil. This is obviously not my final shape, but this is the gist of it. And this is how the spoolie is doing. I mean, as you can see, it does have a good color payoff, but for me, it's a little bit hard to work with it because, again, it reminds me of pomades because it has that soft, creamy, good color payoff consistency to it, which if you like that, it's great. But I, for me personally, it's hard to work with that, maybe because my brows are sparse and they need something less opaque. One thing I will say though, as far as the pencil itself, is that it is a wooden pencil, which means that you're gonna have to keep sharpening it if you want a fine point to get more precision. It's not like one of those twisty pencils that come in like a certain shape, you know? All right, I'm going to quickly finish the rest of my makeup and come back and show you the lipsticks. Okay, I am back with the rest of my makeup, and the last thing I'm going to apply before running off for the day and doing a wear test on all of these products is lipsticks. Now, I have three colors here, all of which will be listed down below and swatched as well. These lipsticks come in two types of finishes. One is a glossy finish, which I have one color, and then two are satin finish. These are $9 a pop, so not very cheap, but not terribly expensive either. And this is the packaging right here, which I think, again, is very cute. Ties together with the rest of the products. And if you couldn't tell, I'm obsessed with the packaging of all these products. It's just so cute and fitting, and I like it. As far as the marketing claims, it is an intense color with 8-hour moisture, leaves lips silky smooth with a satin finish and creamy texture. These are also Allure Beauty Award winners for 2016, so some high hopes. And I will tell you that I really like these lipsticks a lot. Most of the colors that these come in are natural nude colors, which I'm so down for. Those are my favorite types of colors, but they do come in a couple of brighter colors as well. I think that satin finish is my favorite. I like the glossy finish, but I found that a couple of glossy colors were like shimmery. They just did not look that great on me, but I mean, I think it's everybody's personal preference, but for me personally, I prefer the satin finish a lot better. For my look today, I'm going to go with a color called Nile Nude 500. This is a satin finish, and this is probably my favorite color in the whole collection. I think it's the lightest color in the whole collection as well. You can tell I really like light nude natural colors. The smell of these lipsticks reminds me of the first ever chapstick I got when I was 3 while living in Russia in like the 1990s, but it smells exactly like that. I remember it was like a turquoise bullet, just a very basic chapstick. My grandma got it for me, and this smells just like that. If you know what that smells like, then there you go. But it's a really kind of like a mild chapsticky smell. And without further ado, let's go ahead and apply this. When you apply these on the lips, they're super moisturizing. They honestly feel like lip balms that have color in them, but they do have a good amount of color. I mean, you can see this is not like a tinted lip balm. This is not one of those products. It's a full-on lipstick. It's just so incredibly comfortable and moisturizing, and it does not crumble or cake or crease. It doesn't do anything weird like that. When I apply lighter colors on my lips, which are a little darker, a little brighter, you can sometimes see the streaking. I mean, you can see it a little bit, like it settles into the lines, but it's not terrible. And I think overall I do really, really like the way they sit on the lips and the way they feel and the coverage they get from these lipsticks. I am really happy with the products. I am kind of disappointed with some and kind of amazed with others. There are definitely some amazing products in this line and then some not so great ones. But I will be doing an update at the end of the day showing you how everything lasted and how everything is doing. So stay tuned for that. And I guess with the magic of editing, I'll see you guys in just a second. Okay, it has been about 5 hours, just under 5 hours, since I first applied the makeup this morning. Let me zoom in to show you how everything is doing up close. I'm gonna give you the tour of my face, starting from the top. So the forehead area, moving down to the brows, the liner, which I also applied on my waterline right there. We have the middle of the face area. All right, so this is my face up close and personal, 5 hours into the day and into the makeup. All right, so this is how my makeup is doing 5 hours into the day. I did not blot my face or apply any additional powder. This is how it is since this morning. As you can see, I am producing some oil, and I'm also noticing a little bit of creasing right in my smile line, but nothing too terrible. I guess let's talk about each item that I've applied on my face this morning, and I'm gonna give you my final thoughts on it, how it lasted, and whether or not it is worth the money and whether or not it is worth the investment. First and foremost, the foundation. If you can't tell already, I am not a huge fan of this particular foundation. I love Burt's Bees as a brand, but this product, I'm not a fan. It did not apply that well. It does kind of sit on the skin. It goes on patchy, and it also, like, if you touch your face, the foundation just like comes off. It has a nice finish to it when you first apply it, but everything else about it's just, I'm not a fan. It's also $17. It's not really cheap. Moving down to the mattifying powder foundation, I actually really like this product. It's not the cheapest item out there. Like, you can get something similar, I think, for cheaper, but this is 100% natural, and I do like the way it makes my skin look. I don't think it keeps me matte for the entire day, clearly, but I also did have a dewy foundation underneath, so there is that. So overall, I do like the mattifying powder foundation. I think it is worth a try. It's not the cheapest powder product out there for sure, but it does have some pluses and I enjoy using it, so that's all I can say. All right, moving down to the blush. I know this is only a 5 hour test, but I did wear this a bunch of times all day long, and this does last. I like this product. I don't love that it has a ton of shimmer. I prefer more of like a matte blush, but it's pretty. It lasts all day. It's super easy to apply it, and it blends really well. It's not patchy, unlike the foundation. Not the cheapest price point, but I think that if you get it, at least I don't think you'll be disappointed with it, as long as you like a shimmery blush, because although it does not look shimmery in here, it really is. I mean, like, there's some bling to it. Like, look at that. I know I'm kind of oily right now, but there is some major bling to this blush. Moving down to eyes, I did apply the Burt's Bees eyeliner, which is still holding on strong, and I did notice that it does last all day long. It does not smudge, it doesn't smear. It's not the longest possible liner out there for sure, but it does last for a good while. And again, I love how it goes on creamy, but then you can blend it out pretty easily, and it almost feels like powder when you're blending it out. So I think it's worth a try. And my favorite color, the only one I have, but it's usually like my go-to type of a color for eyeliner, is warm brown. The brow pencil, I personally am not obsessed with. This brow pencil does last all day, but again, like I said in the beginning of the video, it reminds me of like a pomade that's packed into a pencil because it's so creamy and soft and opaque. And if that's your thing, then this is a great product to check out. I like it, but it's not my favorite. But I do think that for what it is, it's good quality stuff. And as far as the lip products, I've been wearing these for months and months and months, and I have to say I do like them a lot. I know they were off because I did have some lunch, so I don't have any lip product on at the moment, and I did that on purpose. I didn't reapply anything because I just want to show you that it does come off. It's not like a long-lasting product, but it does last for a good amount of time. When it does rub off or like fade out, it does so gracefully. Some lip products, at least for me, tend to crumble and dry and cake almost, like just kind of look disgusting. These products don't do that. They disappear into like this thin film, and it's not bad the way they go. The thing I really like about these products is that they're really creamy and really moisturizing, and if you have dry lips like I do a lot of the times, they're so dry they're cracking. These lipsticks are perfect if you want to have a combination of like a lip balm and a lip product in one. I wear these on a daily basis, like to work or something, when I want to have something on my lips as far as color is concerned, but I don't really want to like go all out and apply something that would be drying, or you know, just like I don't want to be anything fancy, but like a little bit of something. These are perfect for that. They're a combination of a good quality creamy lipstick, but also with a little bit of like a lip balm mixed into it. So I like them a lot. I think these are definitely worth checking out for sure. Basically, everything with the liquid foundation I really, really like. So that is it for my video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye.